Hey everyone, Genome here. Come at you with the next episode of my music review series. Today's selection kind of harkens back to basically the year of my birth, which was a nice little coincidence, but it's a song I've been playing for a while from a group that I've always really dug, and that group is none other than Electric Light Orchestra, or ELO as they're colloquially known. The group is basically the brainchild of producer extraordinaire Jeff Lynne, and kind of forays a lot into the prog rock slash pop rock slash symphonic rock or arena rock, you know, and it kind of hybrid, it's like a hybrid of all, and they fuse together. It's an interesting concept. A lot of the music is a little bit uneven, and I think that's a lot of it's done purposefully, you know what I mean? It's like, because I can imagine Jeff's his imagination just go every which way, man, and knowing all the studio magic that he can pull lends one towards creativity. I'll look at the White Album for just a great example of that, of what very talented musicians can do when they're given carte blanche to do what they feel like. So a lot of ELO stuff sounds very different from each other, you know. but anyway, so all that notwithstanding, my poor explanations of what we're even getting into here. I'm going to be taking a selection from probably their best album ever. Definitely had the most hits on it, and what I believe is probably their most complete album, and that's A New World Record from 1976. There's a lot of songs on here that I could be using, but I'm going to try to steer away from the more standard radio hits, because they're not always my favorite. One thing I will say about ELO that I never have cared for is most of the time I do not like their choruses. You know, I love the melodies they throw down, and I love all the verses, but when usually it gets to chorus, I don't know. Sometimes they lose me there. But everything else is so ridiculously strong that I can definitely look past that. You know, that's just me. I'm just a weird music connoisseur. But it's the funny thing about this album is my two favorite songs on it are the bookends. The very first song, which is Tightrope, and the last song, which is Shangri-La. Well, today I'm going to go ahead and bring to you Shangri-La for a couple different reasons. One off, I think it's an amazing song, and it's a perfect way to end an album. And the second I'll get into after the album, because I know you want to get to it. So let's go ahead without further ado and jump in. I'm going to get it pulled up here. And witness, you know, please witness 5+ minutes of auditory ecstasy. So here we go. 1976, Shangri-La, written by Jeff Lynne and produced by Jeff Lynne. Starts with a nice, little steel underwater guitar. Joined by another one. Dueling. What's the echo and reverb on his voice? And notice how the strings seamlessly just blend in right there, and they just start firing in at the third verse. The third line of the verse. What's the use of changing things? This little piano. Wonder what tomorrow brings. Who knows? Oh, there's a line coming up. Famous fade on Beatles, of Hey Jude. Nice little reference there. Pretty funny on a 5+ minute song, he went right into the vocals within the first 20 seconds. Usually they'll drag out the intros a lot longer than that.
Mm-hmm.
I like his voice coming in a little bit louder than this verse. Multi-tracking there. Had that Beatles on Hey Jude on the keyboard. I love it. And stuff like that. Nice little fill coming up here. There's a traditional roll, the one before it came in like right in the center of the sentence. That was a Ringo West fill right there. Sound like the song's over, right? It's just transitioning into the otherworldly. It's a slight pulse. Time to bring the rest of the band in, albeit slowly. And he brings something else in with him. And there they are. It's like staccato strings. It sounds like from Requiem, Mozart's Requiem. Now notice Jeff's voice in this. Listen how far away and otherworldly he made himself sound, like he's passed on the gates of life. And that's where he's singing from. Kind of a Beachy Boys in the background there. Easy to miss. There you have it. Probably my favorite ELO song from New World Record, and one of my probably top three favorites of theirs, Shangri-La. So what a way to end an album. First you have the normal fade out of a song, and then it fades back in, and you get about 2 more minutes of song, and then it fades back out again really slowly. It's like, you know, you can see this picture of these people who, like I said, have crossed the pale, as it were. They're drifting slowly farther and farther away from you, you know. I don't know. That's the kind of visual imagery I get. Excuse me, sorry, I got a frog in my throat here. But yeah, just a great song on a great album, man. Just that album, there's not a weak song on it. Maybe So Fine. I'm not a really huge fan of that song, but just about every other song in there is super strong and kind of a classic in its own right. But Shangri-La is not really a song you really hear too often from that album, or basically from ELO in particular. And I think it's a shame. I think part of it's because of the length, but it's only like 5 minutes, so it's not really all that long if you get down to it. But for radio play, they don't like songs that fade out and then fade back in for that long. Like, think of Helter Skelter. They fade out and they come back in for basically 2 more minutes of jam, of open jam. It's crazy. So this song is kind of like that. It does a nice little long fade out, kind of like the Beatles on Hey Jude. For those of you who don't know, listen to Hey Jude, and at the end, you have over 3.5 minutes, I think, of them saying, Hey Jude, na 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 na, you know, and it slowly fades. So, Yeah, just I think a super, super cool song. It's super melodic and kind of relaxing, even though the strings can be a little bit jarring if you're trying to put yourself into the ultimate mode of tranquility. But getting past all that now, another reason I picked this song, I said there was two, other than me just liking it being one, is I remember I brought this album with me to a job I had. I used to work for this telecom company, and the owner, boss, he had built the second floor into his house and basically turned it, half of that top floor into an office, huge, huge office for where several of us up there working. And he was a band guy, and just we all live for music, man. And he had these Bose, gigantic Bose speakers. These things were probably about 4 foot across and probably 2 foot high, just enormous things. And he hung them from the corners of the office ceiling. And every now and then, man, after work or whatever, we just crank some music up and frickin' jam out. And this is one of the songs that I would bring in and ask to play. And, you know, we all liked, you know, the classic stuff back then, but, and he really dug it too. But I mean, it's like, just imagine that ending coming in on that slow fade in as the strings come in over sound that's basically just sitting on your chest like an anvil, you know? It was just a thing of beauty, man. And it'd almost bring tears of joy to your eye. It'd be so nice. And I can feel like that, my eyes would start watering sometimes at like Mozart concerts and things like that, just because the sound of the music itself just washes you, and there's nothing like hearing it live and loud, and it's almost like a physical presence on you, you know, certain kind of music. And the end of this song is like that with me. But anyway, me waxing poetic there. That's basically the second reason. It brings me a lot back to a really good time in my life. You know, I was like, what, 21 years old, and you know, I had a dream job with all my friends, and I was traveling around the world and all over the country, and it was an interesting time to be sure. So yeah, there it is. So we have once again Shangri-La from the album A New World Record, written by Jeff Lynne, produced by Jeff Lynne. Basically, it's Jeff Lynne production, and of course ELO. So ELO is definitely a band you should give a try to if you're into something different. Plenty of radio-friendly hits and plenty of really off-the-wall stuff. I could play a lot of different songs of theirs on this series and not feel out of place at all. So anyway, let me know what you think below in the comments if you heard the song before. If not, what did you think about it? Are you a big fan of ELO or just their mantra in general, which was basically, we'll do anything in the recording booth, you know? Anyway, yeah, just let me know what you think. Anyway, so until next time, this is Genome. Just loving him some staccato to end the song. Out.